Happy Kids TV. The Holy Tales.
Go on with the story, Holy. Let's not waste any more time.
It was about 9 o'clock in the morning when Jesus was led to Golgotha by the soldiers for his crucifixion. His cross was in between two thieves who were also being crucified that day. Before putting Jesus on the cross, the soldiers offered him wine, which was mixed with myrrh and would numb his senses. But Jesus refused it. The soldiers took off his clothes and threw a dice to see which one of them would get to keep his robe. A sign which said, "This is Jesus, King of the Jews," was hung at the top of his cross. People who came to watch him being killed shouted,
"He saved other people. Let him save himself."
"Go ahead, King of the Jews. Save yourself."
The soldiers continued to make fun of him and kept on offering him drinks of sour wine. One of the thieves on his side said,
"You say you are the Messiah? Then prove it by saving yourself and us too."
But the other thief on his other side said,
"Don't you fear God? Even when you're dying, you and I deserve to die for the bad things we have done. But this man has done nothing wrong."
Then he turned to Jesus and said,
"Jesus, remember me when you come to rule."
Jesus said,
"You will be with me this day in heaven."
Jesus' mother was there in the crowd with other women and watching all this happening. Jesus saw her standing near one of his disciples whom he loved very much. He looked at his mother and said,
"Woman, he is your son."
Then he turned to his disciple and said,
"From now, she is your mother."
By now, it was almost noontime. Even then, the sky grew dark and the entire land was in complete darkness until 3 in the afternoon. Jesus looked up in the sky and called out,
"My God, my God, why have you forsaken me?"
Then he shouted,
"Father, into your hands I put my spirit,"
and died. Suddenly, the thick veil that hung in the temple was torn apart from top to bottom. The earth shook, rocks split apart, and graves broke open. When the captain of the guard saw all this happening, he said,
"Truly, this man was God's son."
All of Jesus' friends who were watching the crucifixion went home with hearts filled with sadness. The religious leaders did not want the bodies hanging on the crosses the next day because it was the Sabbath. So they asked Pilate to hurry up with the deaths by breaking their legs. The soldiers broke the legs of the two criminals, but seeing that Jesus was already dead, they did not break his legs. However, one of the soldiers stuck his spear into Jesus' side and blood and water flowed out. A man named Joseph from Arimathea asked Pilate if he could bury Jesus' body in a brand new tomb that no one had been buried in yet. He was given permission to take Jesus' body down, while other people brought ointments and perfumes to put on the body, which was the Jewish custom before burial. They wrapped Jesus in special strips of cloth for burial and laid him in the tomb that was like a large cave. A heavy stone was rolled in front of the opening of the tomb. Mary Magdalene and the other woman named Mary stood nearby and saw all of this happen. So, did you all like the story?
I did!
All right. Today's story is about Jesus going home.
Huh? Jesus had a home? No, Jesus' home was heaven. He had no home like us. Am I right, Holy?
Why don't we find that out in the story? Jesus' disciples and his followers were thrilled that he was alive again. They had hoped of a better future because he was alive. They kept asking him questions about when he was going to free Israel and set up his kingdom. They did not clearly understand what Jesus had been actually teaching them.
My Father sets all the plans for his kingdom. I don't even know his plans.
Jesus told them.
When the Holy Spirit comes, you will receive immense power. You will tell people about me, my work, and my teachings. You will tell people right here in Jerusalem, in Judea, in Samaria, and in the whole world.
Jesus told them. Not long after telling them these things, Jesus was taken up to heaven in front of their eyes while they watched. He disappeared into the clouds, and the disciples strained their eyes trying to see where he had gone. While they were still looking, they suddenly saw two men in bright white robes standing with them. One of the men said,
"What are you looking for? Jesus isn't here. He has been taken away and has gone to heaven. Someday, he will come back in just the same way he left."
Wow! That was such a nice story. I loved it, Holy. To watch more videos, please subscribe.
Let's then begin with the story. I am sure you are all going to love it, especially you, Freckles. Early morning on that following Sunday, Mary Magdalene and few other women came to the tomb where Jesus was buried. They hadn't been able to prepare Jesus' body for burial because of the Sabbath, and now that it was over, they could put their offerings of oils and perfumes on him. When they left town to go to Jesus' tomb, the women wondered about how they would move the heavy stone from the opening of the tomb. But when they reached the tomb, they were amazed. The stone had already been moved. The women rushed into the tomb, only to find that Jesus' body was nowhere around. They were confused. Suddenly, two men appeared, who were dressed in bright white robes. The women were terrified to see them, but the two men, who were angels, said,
"Why are you looking inside a tomb for someone who is alive? The one you are looking for isn't here. He has risen from the dead. Do you not remember that he told you he would be crucified and come back to life on the third day?"
The women then remembered Jesus saying that in one of his teachings. Mary Magdalene was standing outside the tomb, trying to understand what might have happened. She started crying when she saw a man standing nearby. The man asked her,
"Why are you crying?"
Mary said, "Sir, please tell where have they taken his body? I will go and get him."
"Mary,"
the man gently said. That is when she realized that it was no one else but Jesus. The women, along with Mary Magdalene, rushed back to town to tell Jesus' disciples that he was alive. The disciples ran to the tomb as fast as they could to see if it was true. Peter ran into the tomb and found the strips of cloth that were used to wrap around Jesus' body were lying neatly folded. He was nowhere there in the tomb. He was alive!
That was the best story ever! I am so, so happy!
Today I'm going to tell you the story about Jesus getting anointed by Mary. So, are you children ready for it?
Oh yes, we are!
Jesus was sent to earth by God, his Father, for a specific reason. He was sent to the earth to help people to connect with God. The end of this plan led to Jesus taking the cross for the sins of the people. He tried over and over to tell his disciples that he was going to die, but they failed to understand his message. Now, the end of his time on earth was coming near, and it was very important for them to understand quickly. Jesus knew that his ministry on earth is going to get over soon enough. He tried telling his disciples about what was coming, but they never really understood. One night, Jesus and his disciples were having dinner at Mary's house with her sister Martha and Lazarus. Martha served dinner, and while they were eating, Mary brought a jar of very expensive perfume. She went up to Jesus and slowly poured the perfume on his feet and wiped them dry using her own hair. The sweet fragrance of the perfume filled up the entire house. Jesus' disciples watched Mary doing this. Some of them got very upset. Judas Iscariot said,
"What a waste of money. This expensive perfume could have been sold for a lot of money, and that money could have been used to help the poor."
Judas did not really care about the poor. He was in charge of the disciples' money, and he often stole from their funds for his own use. Jesus had an answer for Judas's concern. He said,
"Don't stop her from doing such a good thing for me. You will always have poor people around you, but I will not be here much longer. She has poured this perfume on me to prepare my body for burial. I promise that whenever my stories are told throughout the world, this woman's deeds will be mentioned."
Gumbo, you've been keeping very quiet today. Did you not like the story?
Oh yes, I did, Holy. I was concentrating on the story.
Excellent, Gumbo. Well done. Hope you all got the answer correct too. We'll be back soon. Until next time.
To watch more videos, please subscribe.
Plants and trees. On the fourth day, God created the sun to shine in the day, the moon and stars to come out at night. One day, Moses went to Mount Horeb with his sheep. There, God appeared to him as a flame of fire in a bush. Since there was no room anywhere else, they decided to spend the night in a stable. Here, Mary had her baby, Jesus. She wrapped him in a blanket and put him to sleep.
He's got the whole